યસ મેમ.
હવે
તો દેખાશે ને. ગુડ મોર્નિંગ ફ્રેન્ડ્સ, વી આર લર્નિંગ અવર સબ્જેક્ટ મશીન લર્નિંગ 3170-4, એન્ડ ઇન ધેટ વી વોન્ટ ટુ લર્ન ધ મોડ્યુલ ધેટ ઇઝ ઓવરવ્યૂ ઓફ પ્રોબેબિલિટી. ઇન ધેટ વી વોન્ટ ટુ લર્ન સ્ટેટિસ્ટિકલ ટૂલ્સ, કન્સેપ્ટ ઓફ પ્રોબેબિલિટી, રેન્ડમ વેરિયેબલ્સ, ડિસ્ક્રીટ એન્ડ કન્ટિન્યુઅસ ડિસ્ટ્રીબ્યુશન્સ, multiple random variables, central limit theorem, sampling distributions, hypothesis testing, Monte Carlo approximation. This chapter gives us the course outcome that is of number 2. Appreciate the underlying mathematical relationships within and across machine learning algorithms. Okay, so what do we want to know? Machine learning can automatically detect patterns in data and then can be used to uncover patterns to predict future data or to perform other kinds of decision making under uncertainty. What type of uncertainty? At least basically we can say uncertainty, that means the data is available or not, right? Whether we are taking the decision whether it is certain or not, because we may be taking say sample, so will it be giving us the same or equivalent result of the whole data or not, right? So what we are saying is that machine learning can automatically detect patterns in data that can be used to uncover the patterns to predict future data or to perform other kinds of decision making under uncertainty, right? The best way to perform such activities for big data is to use the tools of probability theory, because probability theory can be applied to any situation involving uncertainty. In machine learning, there may be uncertainties in different forms, like arriving at the best prediction of future given the past data, arriving at the best model based on certain data, arriving at the confidence level while predicting the future outcome based on past data, right? Probabilistic approach is used in machine learning for doing all these things, right? So now the learning is closely related to the field of statistics, but the emphasis is in a different direction. Let us learn different tools. What do we typically say? That we train the systems using training data, we test the system using the test data, and we validate the system using the validation data, right? Typically, at least training data and test data is there. Okay, so we train system using training data, and level of the training data, the machine learning algorithm depicts the behavior of the larger data. For sample data, there will be some uncertainty in attribute the sample result to the whole set or population. See, you can relate this to data reduction. Where we have studied the data, we say that we can do data reduction only if we are going to get same or similar result of the whole data set, isn't it? So that's what we are trying to say here also, but here we are including the uncertainty, right? Okay, so how a limited knowledge of a sample set can be used to predict the behavior of a real set with some confidence. That is what we want to do. Now the mathematicians realize what? That even if some knowledge is based on a sample, not the whole data, if we know the amount of uncertainty related to it, then it can be used in an optimum way without causing loss of knowledge, as we can see in the figure. Knowledge of sample plus knowledge of uncertainty, and that is equal to useful knowledge. Probability theory provides a mathematical foundation for quantifying this uncertainty of knowledge, as the knowledge about the training data comes in the form of interdependent feature sets, the conditional probability theories will be useful, and especially we can say the Bayes theorem. How two data set will behave, we will see. How data set will behave, that we'll see. Then we can say from mathematical from mathematical function behind each data distribution, data spread out from mean and variance can be understood. Choosing the samples from this distribution sets, we should to what extent the sample is representing the actual behavior of the full data set. This, along with the test of hypothesis principles, build the basis for finding out the uncertainty in the training data set to represent the actual data set, which is the fundamental principle of machine learning. So next, what we want to learn is concept of probability, frequentist and Bayesian interpretation. Probability we use in daily life. All of you must be knowing, just to recall, that heads and tails when coin is flipped are equal. Means coin is flipped many times, the coin will land heads a same number of times as it lands tails. Right? We mean to say that if we are flipping the coin for say 10 times, then 5 times we should be having head, 5 times we should be having the tail, right? This is the frequentist interpretation of probability. It represents the long run frequencies of events. Another interpretation of probability tries to quantify the uncertainty of some event and thus focuses on information rather than repeated trials. This is called the Bayesian interpretation of probability. What we consider is probability tries to quantify uncertainty of some event and focuses on information rather than repeated trials, right? That is called the Bayesian interpretation of probability. As for example, coin flipping. is interpreted as the coin is equally likely to land heads or tails when we flip the coin next. The reason the Bayesian interpretation can be used to model the uncertainty of events is that it does not expect the long-run frequencies of the events to happen. It's for example, to compute the probability of India winning 2022 Cricket World Cup final. That event can happen only once and can't be repeated over and over again to calculate its probability. But still, we should be able to quantify the uncertainty about the event, and which is only possible if we interpret probability the Bayesian way. Another, we are starting a new software implementation project for a large customer and want to compute the probability of this project getting into customer escalation based on data from similar projects in past. Are you getting that? What we want is, we want to compute the probability of a new project getting into customer escalation based on what? Based on data from similar projects in past, right? See, we predict the future based on the past only, isn't it? Another example, we want to compute the probability of tumor to be malignant or not based on the probability distribution of such cases among the patients of similar profile. It is not possible to do a trial, and the Bayesian concept is valid computing the uncertainty. The basic concept of machine learning, what we say, that is, with a limited set of training data, we use as a representative of a large set of actual data, and through probability distribution, we try to find out how an event which is matching with the training data can represent the outcome with some confidence. So we want to know the foundation rules of probability. You almost all know those things, but let us recall so we can use it for our subject. Okay, so what are the foundation rules? It says P of A denotes the probability that the event A is true. Is it true? Is it false? It can be, right? But when we say P of A, it denotes the probability that the event is true. Which event? Event A. We are not talking of event B, isn't it? We are talking of saying P of A, that means that event is true. What event is true? Today, rain will be there, right? For example, we can say that India is going to win cricket match in World Cup final 2022. Yes. So we can say that event is true. Yes, we wish to, isn't it? When we are saying P of A, then we say that that event is true, and we are saying with some confidence, some probability, that this much is the probability that India is going to win in the next cricket match, right? Okay.
expression 0 is less than or equal to p of a is less than or equal to 1. Note that the probability of event happening lies between 0 where p of a is equal to 0 means the event will definitely not happen. P of a is equal to 1 means the event will definitely happen. The notation P of A bar denotes the probability of the event, not A. This is defined as P of A bar is equal to 1 minus P of A. It is also common practice to write A is equal to 1 to mean the event A is true. A is equal to 0, that means the event is false. See, this P of A is equal to 0 and A is equal to 0 is not same, isn't it? When we are saying P of A is equal to 0, it means the event will definitely not happen. We are saying the probability of the event to happen is equal to 0. Here what we are saying is, we are saying A is equal to 0. That means the event is false, right? The event is false. So, this is a binary event where the event is either true or false, but it cannot be something indefinite. The probability of selecting an event A from a sample size of x is defined as P of A is equal to n by x, where n is the number of times the instance of event A is present in the sample of x. So, probability of union of two events. A and B are called mutually exclusive if they can't happen together. We can say India winning the Football World Cup 2018 and Brazil winning the Football World Cup 2018 are two mutually exclusive events and can't happen together. Right? Winner is only one, right? It cannot be the both, isn't it? So, mutually exclusive events are there. Both cannot win together, right? So, for any two events, A and B, we can define the probability of A or B as P of A union B, that is equal to P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. And that is equal to P of A plus P of B if A and B are mutually exclusive. Joint probability. The probability of the joint event A and B is defined as the product rule. How? That is P of A comma B, that is equal to P of A intersection B, and that is equal to P of A by B. What does that mean? That is probability of event A based on the event B, right? And into P of B, right? See, if you see the multiplication, that is the way we have written, say A by B and into B. So we can say we can cancel BB and that is A, right? Isn't it? This way we typically used to understand, isn't it? Where it is non-technical understanding, okay?
where P of A by B is defined as the conditional probability of event A happening if event B happens. I can say a student X from your class will be having first rank, will be having first rank if he is passed in all the subjects, isn't it? Can we say that? Obviously, if he is not passing the subjects, how can he get first rank or second rank or pass class? Are you getting this? What we want to say is that conditional probability of event A happening if event B happens, right? Based on this joint distribution on two events P A comma B, we can define the marginal distribution. How we can define the marginal distribution? That is, P of A is equal to sigma. P of A comma B, that is equal to sigma. P of A by B is equal to B into P of B is equal to B. See, this is the same equation. I mean to say this one. P of A by B into P of B, right? What we have considered is this B is equal to B, right? P of A by B is equal to B and B is equal to B, right? P of A by B is equal to B into P of B is equal to B, okay? And what we want to do is we want to find the marginal distribution. So what we are having is we are having the sigma also, okay? So what we are saying is summing up the all probable states of the B gives the total probability formula, which is called as sum rule or the rule of total probability, right? What we say is the rule of total probability or otherwise sum rule, isn't it? Same way, P of B can be defined as P of B is equal to P of A, B, that is equal to P of B by A, and what is that? That A is equal to A into P of A is equal to A, right? This is the joint probability and total probability. This formula can be extended for the countably infinite number of events in the set, and chain rule of probability can be derived if the product rule is applied multiple times, as P of X 1 to N, right? What we can say, that is equal to P of x1 into P of x2 by x1 into P of x3 by x2 comma x1 into P of x4 by x1, x2, x3, and you can say up to P of xn based on x1 to n minus 1, right? So, what we say is the rule of probability, chain rule of probability, that means what will be having x1. If you are saying that P of x1, then into P of x2 by x1. If you are saying that with that, some more variables, more variables. So, x3 upon x2 into x1, sorry, x3 based on x2, x1. X4 is based on X1, X2, X3. We mean to say that one event occurs based on the condition of other. When we want to have, say, third event, that is based on first two events. Fourth event, if we want to have, then we consider that based on say previous three events. And if we want to consider say nth event, and that is based on all the n minus 1 event, right? So with that we can get the chain rule of probability.
Conditional probability. We define the conditional probability of event A given that event B is true and P of A by B. That means probability of A based on the B event has already occurred. That is equal to P of A comma B divided by P of B. If P of B is greater than 0, where P of A comma B is the joint probability of A and B and can be denoted as P of A intersection B, right? Similarly, P of B by A, B comma A divided by P of A, if P of A is greater than 0. So let us take the example so we can have the idea. In a toy shop, the automated machine produces few defective pieces. Toy shop is there. Automatic machine is there which produces the, right? It produces few defective pieces. It is observed that in a lot of 1000 toy parts, 25 are defective. From 1000, 25 are defective. Okay, let us go ahead. If two random samples are selected for testing without replacement, meaning that the first sample is not put back to the lot and thus the second sample is selected from the lot of 999 from the lot, right? Calculate the probability that both samples are defective. So what's the solution? Let A denote the probability of first part being defective and B denote the second part being defective. Here we have to employ the conditional probability of the second part being found defective when the first part is already found defective. We want both parts as defective. So what do we want to say is, first is already defective and now we want to find the probability that second is also defective. So for that, what we can say is, for P of A, right, P of A, that is first part is defective. For that, we can say that 25 divided by 1000. Why? Because we have already said that 25 from 1000 are defective. So 25 divided by 1000, that is equal to 0.025, isn't it? As we are selecting the second sample, now without replacing the first sample, we are not putting the sample back. So now what will happen, that we are having 999 pieces left and from that 24 are defective. Why 24? Why not 25? Because the defective one piece is already being taken, right? So now we can say we are having 24 defective pieces out of 999 pieces left in the lot, right? So P of B by A was already defective. Now, B is also found as defective, that is equal to
24/999, and that is equal to 0.024, right? Now P of A comma B, that is equal to P of A intersection B, and that is equal to P of B based on A into P of A, and that is equal to 0.024 into 0.025, that is equal to 0.006006, which is the probability of both parts being found defective, right? So we'll stop here.